Alexandria City Public Schools requires an evacuation response for many different emergency situations. As mentioned in video 2 of this series, ACPS prepares for emergencies that are less common, such as an active threat or violent intruder inside the building. An active threat is when an individual has entered a school building with the intent to cause harm to an individual or individuals inside the building. In situations like these, students, staff, and teachers must immediately evacuate their building and proceed to their school's designated safe place location.
All right, so at this time, we're going to do our active threat barricade drill.
Active threat events are critical events that require proper planning and training. For this reason, students and staff practice two primary responses to an active threat at an age-appropriate level. The primary response is evacuation. If there is an active threat, always act quickly and remove yourself and others from the threat area.
Good morning, teachers and staff. Everyone stop and listen to the announcement.
We're getting ready to do our active threat lockdown drill.
Okay, we need to barricade. Adonis and James, grab the cabinet.
The other response is a barricade, or what is commonly referred to as lockdown. A barricade is recommended in spaces where individuals do not have time to evacuate during an active threat, or the threat is within imminent proximity to their location. This mainly applies to office spaces or classrooms. Individuals in these areas will place as many furniture items as possible at the entry point, separating them from the active threat near their room. It is important to note that all active threat emergencies will require a response from law enforcement. In all cases, ACPS administrators will not allow re-entry into a building unless law enforcement has given the all clear and verified that the threat or adversary is no longer present. Schools resume normal operations after an evacuation at the direction of on-scene first responders investigating the incident and school administration, working in close coordination with central office leadership. Critical incidents like these, although rare, can be very chaotic and confusing for families. It is important to follow all instructions provided via Parent Square or other notification platforms. Please do not go to the school, but we ask that you be ready to receive information regarding reunification instructions from various ACPS notification platforms. The safety of our students and staff is always our utmost priority at ACPS.